Welcome to Aurora Chemistry for Everyone. Here we will see how to find hybridization of NH3 and also we go to see that how to draw orbital diagram for NH3 ammonia molecule. First let us see what is hybridization. Hybridization is a phenomenon in which orbitals of different energy intermix together and produce orbitals of equivalent energy and same shape. So in ammonia, nitrogen is a central atom. So to find that hybridization, we should know that valence electron, nitrogen group number is 15th. That means 5 valence electrons are present. So to find that hybridization, that valence electron you divide by valency of hydrogen. It is a monovalent, that means valency of hydrogen is 1. So we will get 5. If the number is 5, then sp3d, then if the number is 4, then sp3 hybridization, 3 means sp2, then 2 means sp hybridization. So but for nitrogen it is 5, sp3d, but that there is no d orbitals in nitrogen, only sp orbitals are present in nitrogen. It means that it will form sp3 hybridization plus 4 sp3 hybridization and another one number is there, isn't it? So just like a one lone pair, it is present in ammonia. So first let us draw that electronic configuration for nitrogen. 2s, 2p, 2 electrons in 2s orbital, and then here each one electron in 2p orbitals. In excited state, actually that the electrons move to next orbital, but the d orbital is not present in nitrogen. So even in the excited state also, nitrogen's electrons will present in 2s orbital, just like a lone pair. So we can write that now, this is ground state, so now we can write that hybrid state. Hybrid state, you will get that they all mix together and we will get that 4 sp3 orbitals. So this is sp3 orbitals. So in the first orbital 2 electrons, then remaining all other orbitals we have only 1 electron only. In ammonia, nitrogen is attached to 3 hydrogen. So these 3 hydrogen will give that 1 electron here and it form a bond. So 3 hydrogen will attach. We have that sp3 hybridization, and how many lone pair is present? 1 lone pair electron is present in this. What is the shape of this one? Actually that it should be a tetrahedral, but that due to this lone pair electron, the shape is little distorted and it gets that pyramidal shape. So the shape is pyramidal shape. Now let us draw that orbital diagram for this one. So to draw that orbital diagram, just draw 3 lines and this line should be little closer compared to the tetrahedral, because that this lone pair electron is present, isn't it? So this lone pair electrons, the repulsion is very high, so that is why it will push that this bond to down. That means the bond angle is reduced. So to draw that hybrid orbital, see that the hybrid orbitals, one lobe is little bigger and another lobe is little smaller. So first 4 orbitals, hybrid orbitals we go to draw. So one bigger lobe and another small lobe. Then the same way here also we go to draw. Then the third hybrid orbital. Then after that 4th hybrid orbital. Okay. Hybrid orbital. How many hydrogen atoms are here? 3 hydrogen atoms. So the 3 hydrogen atom, only s orbital is it. So the s spherical shape, 3 hydrogen atoms will attach to this. And what happens to this? The first, the topmost one, this is the lone pair. Lone pair will present in this loop. So due to this lone pair, the bond angle is reduced to 107 degree in ammonia. So this is the orbital diagram. So that in ammonia, the hybridization is sp3, one lone pair is present and the shape is pyramidal, then the bond angle is 107 degree. Thanks for watching.